Students, next experiment is study of shift registers, okay, using the IC7495. Okay, so we are going to see CISO, CIPO, PISO and PIPO, that is serial in, serial out, serial in, parallel out, then parallel in, serial out and parallel in, parallel out. Okay, now this is the 7495 IC, students. Okay, DS is used for the serial input. Now D3, D2, D1, D0, these are the parallel outputs, as you can see, and here we can obtain the outputs. Okay, so pin number 13, 12, 11, 10 are used for the output pins. Okay, and there are two clock pins over here, clock 9. Okay, you can see clock 9, that is used for serial input, and clock 8 is used for parallel input. Okay, and you can see pin number 7 is ground and pin number 14 is VCC. Okay, so now we can see here, students. So DS is used, DS is the serial input data. Okay, D3, D2, D1, D0 are the parallel data inputs. Okay, M is the mode control, and you can see M is 1 for loading the parallel data. M has to be kept high when we are loading the parallel data. M has to be kept low when we are entering the serial data. Clock 2 is meant for parallel input data. Clock 1 is meant for serial input data. Q3, Q2, Q1, Q0, they are the parallel output of the shift register. Now, first operation is CIPO, serial in, parallel out. Now, to perform serial in, parallel out, we have to consider a 4-bit data. Let it be 1101. Now, since it is serial input, so that's why the mode control is made 0. And clock 1 is connected to the pulsar or the monopulse. Now you can see the serial input is converted into the parallel output. You can see the table now. Now according to the table, when we are giving a clock pulse, okay, the first LSB is 1, students, it is 1. Okay, so Q3, output Q3 is 1. Next we are serially giving the input 0. So now Q3 is 0, and this 1 which was there in Q3, now it got shifted to Q2. Now again at the third pulse we are giving the data as 1. Okay, so this 1 is coming and this 0 and 1 got shifted. Okay, now at the fourth pulse, students, again new one has come, so this 101 got shifted by one position, so we are getting the parallel data 1101. So now this is your serial input and parallel output. Okay, so the next is CISO, students, that is serial input and serial output. So as you see here, you can see as at the next clock pulse, okay, the serial in parallel out is done. Okay, so we got the output as 1101. Now when we observe the outputs for serial in, serial output, we are supposed to see only the Q0 bit, students. Okay, so at the first clock pulse, 1 is entered. So we are only observing Q0, and Q3, Q2, Q1 will be don't care. Okay, so Q0 is 1. At the second pulse, 0 is obtained. At the third pulse, 1 is obtained. And then next, again 1 is obtained. So we can see serially we are getting the data inputs first one by one. First we got 1, then we are getting 0, then we are getting 1, and at last we are getting 1. Okay, that is our CISO operation, students, serial in, serial out. Next we will see parallel in, parallel out. Now for parallel in, parallel out, it's a mode control is high because we are loading the parallel data, and the other clock, pin number 8 clock, will be enabled. Okay, so now we have the parallel input. So we will give the inputs at a time, and whatever inputs we have given, students, the same outputs we will get. Okay, so it's the easiest operation out of all the 4 operations, because we are giving the inputs parallelly and we will obtain the outputs also parallelly. Now the next one is parallel input and serial output. Now for that purpose, your mode control is made 1, because again we are loading parallel data, and we are using pin number 8, okay, for entering the parallel inputs. So the parallel inputs are D3, D2, D1 and D0. Okay, now since it is parallel in, serial out, again the clock connection we need to change. So initially it was clock number, clock pulse is applied to pin number 8. Now since we are supposed to get serial data, now the clock is going to be applied to pin number 9, and the mode control is made 0. okay, for obtaining serial output. Now you can see parallel in serial output. So parallelly we are entering the data, students. Let the data be 1101, but while obtaining the output we have to focus on the Q0 bit. We will not see the Q3, Q2, Q1 bit, because as the name suggests, it is parallel in serial output. So that's why first we'll get 1, then serially we'll get the output, then we'll get 0, then at the next pulse we'll get 1, and at the fourth pulse we'll get 1. So that is the operation of parallel in serial out. And you need to remember, students, first the mode control is made 1, then it is made 0, and first the clock was connected to pin number 8, and then the clock is connected to pin number 9. That's how we do PSU operation. Thank you, students. Okay, then clock is starting. Okay, so now all of you look at the trainer kit, students. Okay, so the IC used is 7495 IC. Okay, now you can see the connection, students. The serial input is connected to the pin number 1. So you can see pin number 1 is connected to the serial input. Here you can see, students. So this is the input, okay, and we have connected the input to the pin number 1 of the IC. So you can see the pin number 1 of the IC is connected to the input. So the input is connected serially. So this is serial input, parallel output. Okay, after that the pin number 6 is connected to mode. Okay, pin number 6 is connected to the mode. Okay, you can see here is the mode, and since we are loading the serial data, students, we are loading the serial data, so that is why mode control is made 0. Okay, now since we are loading serial data, pin number 9 we are using as the clock pulse. Okay, so pin number 9 is used as the clock pin. Okay, you can see it's connected to the mono pulse. Okay, pin number 9 is connected to the mono pulse. Okay, so that is done. Then the serial input is going to be converted into parallel data. Now we will see the output, students. Okay, and we'll apply the clock pulse. Okay, we'll apply the clock pulse, and you can see the output is 0. We apply the clock pulse, and then you can see the first output Q3 bit is 1. Q3 bit is 1. Okay, now again I am loading 0. Now 0 is loaded. Look at the input, students. Now 0 is loaded serially, and the pulse is applied. When pulse is applied, the 0 which is loaded comes to Q3 position, and the 1 got shifted to Q2. You can see that. Then again you see the input we are going to change. So then next input we are entering is 1. I am giving a clock pulse. You can see the 1 is occupying Q3 position, and the 0 is shifted, 1 is also shifted. So the output is 101. Okay, students, after that we are again changing the input. Okay, serially we are changing the input. The input is changed. Then I am applying the mono pulse. You can see the parallel output, students. It is 1101. Okay, so the parallel output is obtained. So we are providing the input serially, and we are getting the output parallelly. So you can see the display, students. It is 1101 that we are getting the parallel output, and while providing the serial input we are getting the parallel output. Thank you. So next experiment is CISO, that is serial in serial out. We'll be doing it now. Okay, so the next one is serial input serial output. Now in case of your serial input serial output, okay, you have to use data DS. Okay, this is enabled now. Now while observing the output, you should not observe the outputs obtained at Q3, Q2 and Q1. This is don't care condition. Only at Q0 you have to observe the output. That much you should remember for CISO, students. Okay, already we got the output. Okay, when we are using CPO, serial in parallel out, we have already got this output 1101. Okay, after that at the fifth clock pulse you can see 0 is loaded and 0 is obtained. Similarly 1 is loaded, 1 is obtained. Like that we can see, students. Now let us go to the kit. Okay, Remember one thing, students, Q naught bit output only we have to see. Q naught position output only we have to see. The other Q3, Q2, Q1 will be don't care. Okay. Now come to this board, students. Now you can see, students, the outputs are Q1, 1, 0, 1, Q3, Q2, and Q1 and Q0. 1, 1, 0, 1. That's the output which we have obtained from the previous operation. Now what we have to do, we have to provide serial input. Okay. We will not check the outputs of Q3, Q2 and Q1. We are only focusing on the output at Q0. Fine, students. So now I'm applying a mono pulse and I have provided the input as 1. So the output of Q0 is 1. When the input given is 1, the output obtained is also 1. Okay, fine. Now what we are doing, we are giving the input as 0. When we give the input as 0 and apply the pulse, mono pulse clock, then we will get the output as 0. You can see the output we are getting as 0. Look at the connection, students. The output we are getting 0. Next, when we are applying the pulse, okay, and with the input given is 1, so the output obtained is also 1. Again, we are applying a mono pulse and the input given is 1, so the output obtained is also 1. So this this shift register is now acting in CISO mode, serial in, serial out. Now next we'll see parallel in, parallel out. Fine, students. So students, next is parallel in, parallel out. Okay, so slight changes we need to make. The clock is now gone to pin number 8. Okay, so clock is connected to pin number 8 and the mode is high. Mode is high, clock is connected to pin number 8. Now what we are going to see, parallel in, parallel out. So the okay, so the input which we are giving is 1101. Okay, now we will see the, after applying the clock pulse, we applied the mono pulse and you can observe the outputs over here. Students, it is 1101. Whatever input we gave, same output we are giving at, after giving a clock pulse. So that is our PPO, parallel in, parallel out. Next we'll go for PSO, parallel in, serial out. The next operation, students, it is parallel in, parallel out. So for that, in loading the data parallelly, we need to make the mode control 1. Okay, so the parallel inputs are now, you can see 1101. These are the parallel inputs. Okay, after that, what we have to do, we have, in order to get the serial output, we need to change the clock. Okay, so initially the clock was connected to pin number 8. In order to obtain serial output, again the clock position has to be changed. Now it has to be connected to pin number 9. And initially for loading parallel data, the mode control was made 1. Now in order to obtain the serial output, the mode control is made 0. Okay, now after applying each clock pulse, we can see the output at Q0. Because we are going to obtain the output in a serial mode. So we will not see the outputs of Q3, Q2, Q1. We will only see the output at Q0 position. So serially we will get the output one by one. When we are inputting the data as 1101, okay, at one pulse you will get the output as 1. At second pulse at 0, third pulse 1 and fourth pulse 1. So at Q0 we are getting the outputs serially. That is our PSO operation. So remember 2 points, students. First the mode control is made 1 and after that it got changed to 0, and initially the clock was connected to pin number 8 for parallel loading of data, and after that, in order to obtain the serial output, the clock position is changed to pin number 9. Okay, and then we are supposed to observe the outputs at Q0. Okay, we will not see this Q3, Q2, Q1 will be don't care. Only at Q0 we'll see the output. Okay, now let us see the kit. Okay, now you can see, students, parallel data are loaded. Okay, so you can see it is 1101. Okay, once the parallel data is loaded, we are changing the clock position now. Initially it was there in position 8 or 9, no? It was there in 8, now it is changed to 9. Okay, as we are supposed to see the serial output, okay, it is changed to 9 now. Now you See the mode. Mode was initially at 1, now it is at 0. Okay. Now you see the output. You see the output only at Q0 position because it is piezo. So serially we are supposed to check the output, students. Okay. Now you look at the monopulse, student. Okay. So once the pulse is pressed, okay, you see the output now. The output is 0. Again it is pressed. The clock is pressed. The output is 1. Okay. It is pressed. The output is again 1. Okay. So it is 1011 obtained serially. So parallelly we have loaded the data and we obtained the data serially. That is our piezo operation. Okay. So shift register experiment is done, students. Thank you.